Thank you for watching.
Listening.
Thank you for listening. We'll be talking to Andro, Angel, and Trinity today about the sports and the activities that they do. On to the show. Welcome, Warriors, to the Alamany High School Podcast. This is episode 34. I am Callder Griffith, and I am your host, and my co-host here is named...
Demi Trepanier.
All right, so we're going to recap about last week. The luau took place. The attendance and ticket sales were great. Just one tip, don't backflip in enclosed areas, because we'll not end well. To sports, the girls' volleyball team started its season and is currently 9-0. The Warriors won the Chatsworth tournament over the weekend, and senior Renee Wheeler was voted the tournament MVP. We also defeated Van Nuys on Tuesday in three sets in our home opener. Katie Howard had 6 aces, 8 digs, and 4 kills against Van Nuys. Good job, Katie. The football team played in its first game of the season on Friday night and beat San Fernando 36-7. Wow. Tripp Mitchell threw for 199 yards, and William Camacho had 110 rushing yards.
Okay, so here are some of the upcoming events this week. The religion department is taking donations today and Friday to help out the victims of the hurricane in Texas. Checks are accepted. Just write them out to the school and put Hurricane Harvey in the note section. Campus ministry and Sister Sarah can answer any questions you may have. Homecoming is coming up. September 30th is the dance, so just get ready for homecoming. One of our podcast hosts, Macho Man Andro, it will be featured this week in a story by ABC7. And today we actually have him here to talk to us about it.
Thank you guys for having me. So next week on Tuesday, September 5th, ABC7 will be on campus to talk to me about my interviews and how I'm a full-time student and an interviewer on the side. I've been interviewing since I was 10 years old, and I met ABC7 at a press junket a few weeks ago. And I got a phone call last week, and we're going forward with it.
How are you going to prepare for such a big news company to come out and interview you?
I think I'm just gonna I don't need to study for it. I just know what I'm gonna talk about. I'm gonna talk about my career, how I started it, what I did, what I want to do, just keep going with my career.
Okay, well, thank you. Calder, do you have anything?
Andro, would you like to do this as a profession when you're older?
I do want to do this as a profession. One of the dreams that I have is I want to be the youngest talk show host, to make it out in the big time. So, Jimmy Fallon, I'm going to be the next Jimmy Fallon, hopefully.
Watch out.
Is that your role model? Do you have any other role models besides him?
Yeah, Conan O'Brien, Jimmy Fallon, James Corden. Yeah, I got a lot of role models in this industry.
What is that? That's the karaoke.
Carpool karaoke.
Yeah, carpool karaoke.
It's going to be hard to beat, but it's good. You can beat it.
Oh, and then one other thing. We're going to be trying to get... ABC is trying to see if me and Jimmy Kimmel can do something next week for the story. So after school, I believe I have to go to ABC7. We're going to do something over there, and then that's going to lead to something with Jimmy Kimmel and I. So I'm really excited.
Wow.
That will be awesome. Yeah. We'll be really tuning excited in to watch that.
Senior Sunrise is coming up September 8th, so remember to put that in your calendar. The Grandparents Mass is September 10th. Make sure to come and you bring your grandparents.
Back to sports really quickly. The football team has its second road game Friday against J. Sarah and San Juan Capistrano. It is scheduled for 7 at the moment. The freshmen traveled and the JV team plays at home, both on Thursday and both against J. Sarah. The girls' golf team is scheduled to play a match today at Hanson Dam against Marlboro at 4 p.m., but that might be postponed due to the heat. As we all know, we're in a heat wave, and it's very, very hot. The boys' water polo squad is playing its first official game today at Burroughs at 3:30. Cross country also gets the season going this week at the Riverside Showcase in Riverside. With us to talk about the cross country team is junior Angel Castro.
Hey, guys.
Hi. Okay, so how is the team doing right now?
The team is looking actually really good this year, far better than we expected due to the fact that we lost almost all the seniors on our varsity team last year. But this year, Coach Newman, and with the help of the rest of the team, we were able to get some new bodies that look very promising, so we're very excited about that.
So the Riverside Showcase is your first meet this year. How do you feel about that?
I feel ready, and the rest of the guys on the team too, due to the fact also that we ran that course last year for CIF prelims and finals, and also that the Riverside Showcase, it's only 2.25 miles, not the full 3-mile course. So it's pretty flat, and we're looking forward to running some fast times.
How many schools are there?
Typically, in an invitational, it depends how big the invite should be, because the Riverside Showcase has only been going on for a couple of years now. So we're not really sure how many schools will be there. But in a race, usually up to at least 20 teams.
So besides you, who are some other returners this year? I know that seniors are now gone.
So some returning runners we have this year is my friend Jesse Lozano, Robert Ruiz. We have seniors Diego Valenzuela, Jonathan Doubt, and we have some new freshmen too, and sophomores like Riles Neff, who look very promising. So we're looking to build the team.
So we heard that in preparation for the season, your team trained over the summer in high altitude. Where was that, and like, how did it go?
That was at Fraser Park, actually, and it was tough, but we were able to get really fast out of it. You know, we had a lot of uphill mileage, mile repeats on trail runs, and it was really good.
So how does that help you, like, in a high altitude versus, like, regular altitude? Is there a difference in...
Yes, it's a big difference, because in the altitude, you know, the oxygen is more... There's more pressure on the oxygen, so, you know, it helps you run faster times because you're forced to push your body to, you know, beyond its limits.
And so what was the hardest part about doing that, the high altitude training?
The hardest part was being able to push each other, because the way we see it as runners and coaches is that it's not how fast you get there, but it's the fact that you don't stop, that you keep pushing.
And so you were up there, did you guys see any wild animals?
We did. On the way, you know, my friend John and a couple other kids in the van, we were able to see a bear on the way back from the general store.
So. A bear, that's crazy. So what are some of the team goals this year?
Team goals would probably be make it to CIF, because we have a lot of people turning heads saying that, you know, we're not going to do enough, that we're not going to make it far because we lost all the seniors. So we're looking forward to proving those people wrong.
Right. And how did you guys do last year?
Last year, for the first time in 17 years, we were able to reach CIF finals.
Wow.
So do you have any individual goals for yourself or something you want to accomplish this year?
Yes, I'm looking forward to hit a 15:35 3-mile. On top of that, you know, keep pushing my teammates beyond their limits, because this is as much as a team sport as it is individually.
What are some of the events that cross country will do this year?
We don't do much like as events, you know, like fundraisers, but we do have a Cardinal and Gold meet, you know, where we decide our varsity runners. But other than that, you know, it's just, we just go about for our season.
And which ones are the most challenging?
The most challenging course race we have is called the Mount Sac Invitational. It's one of the largest high school invitationals in the world. You know, we have the sweepstakes race, we have individual races. It's really competitive. It's a very tough course, and we're looking forward to it.
Are there any new courses on your schedule this year that you're not familiar with?
Yes, we have the new Cool Breeze Invitational and the Dana Hills Nike Invitationals, which as a team we're all excited for, because they're very flat courses, and that's going to prep us up for the league meets coming up.
So you were talking about Mount Sac, and can you compare that course to every other course you do?
Mount Sac, you know, that course has been alive since probably the 70s. So the big thing about Mount Sac is that there's three big hills. There's Poop Out Hill, Reservoir Hill, and then there's the switchbacks. And if you can run like a really fast time there, you know, coaches really look forward to seeing what you can do.
So are there any other activities you participate in school? Like, do you do track also or just cross country?
I also do track. And other than that, you know, I'm just a regular guy. I don't really partake in any, well, I am in NHS, but, you know, other than that, just running and doing good in school.
And then are there any other things that, like, you're looking forward to this year? Any, like, big things?
I'm looking forward to, you know, taking my first AP test, because this is the first year I'm taking AP exams and, you know, taking honors classes. So I'm looking forward to see, you know, how I'll manage.
And then any things you aren't excited for?
Yeah, it's the same old every year. You know, I just go about my business. So, you know, everything looks pretty fine right now.
So that's all the questions we have for you, Angel. Thank you for coming to our podcast today.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Hi, this is Alan Green, and I play football. You're listening to the Alan Meany High School Podcast.
The volleyball team goes on the road today, and the varsity girls play at 4:30 against Valley View. Then the team will travel to play a tournament over the weekend in Las Vegas. Here to talk about that more is Trinity Conner.
Hey, it's Mama Trinidad in the his house, coming at you live.
Okay, Trinity, how does the team look this year?
It looks really good. Our hitting is remarkable. Our defense is extraordinary, and we're definitely trying to get that banner up again.
Right. And what are some of your team goals?
Our team goals is obviously to get a banner. We're also trying to get more connected as a team, even though we already are. We're just aiming for the highest opportunity that we can get, which is a banner.
So what are some of your individual goals this year?
My individual goal is to definitely get back on the court, since I am an injured player right now. Hopefully I'm not out for the entire season, but my goal is to just be able to play.
Nice. Okay, so what is your biggest, like, the team challenges this year?
Team challenges that we have is probably filling in our seniors' positions, even though we have already had a great players come in and definitely fill those in. But we can do better. We also are obviously just trying to get that banner and trying to go back to CIF.
Great, thank you.
Okay, Trinity, before you go, we want to know if you have any jokes for us.
Yep, sure do. How does the moon cut its hair?
I don't know, how does the moon cut its hair?
Eclipse it.
All right, you can leave now.
I thought mine was good. It was a good joke.
All right, thank you, Warriors, for listening. That was our episode 34 podcast for today. Remember to stay tuned, because next week is episode 35 with Andro talking about his ABC interview. And then episode 36 the next week with Angelo and Trinity, who you heard from today. Also, stay tuned, because we have a lot more hosts, including Kyle Vergara, Hannah Vera, Caitlin Walling, Autumn Thompson, Steven Surmay. Thank you, Warriors, for listening. I am Callder Griffith.
And I'm Demi Trepanier.
And that was our Alumni podcast. Au revoir.